Hi and welcome back to my channel. Today is Pro Audio Amplifier Dyno time. I have an old school amplifier. This one is around 20 years old, maybe older. This amplifier is a T.amp TA 1400. This range of amplifiers were the best bang for the buck back in the early 2000s. Today there is a newer version. It's a TA 1400 MKX and this amp is rated around 570 watts. I also found a manual where it says 2x450 watts into 8 ohms.
The amplifier is connected to my dummy load. I have 4 resistors, so I have both channels loaded for the dyno test. And I use a sound interface as a preamp, and this one delivers more than 1 volt, so we can bring the amplifier into clipping to test the output power. I'm starting with a continuous power test, 1 kHz input signal into an 8 ohm load, both channels driven. Clipping starts here. Capture the signal and we are at 96 volts. I got an output power of around 590 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Continuous power test, but this time with a 50 Hz input signal. Oops, bad clipping. I go back. And I'm calculating with 94.8 volts. With a 50 Hz input signal, the amplifier delivers 576 watts of continuous power into an 8 ohm load, both channels driven into full power. Let's have a look at the clipping behavior. I turned off the backlight so you can see the clipping behavior of the amplifier. Here's my signal level. You have to watch at this point. Here are the clip LEDs, they turn red, and here you can see on the scope if the amplifier is starting to clip. And now I give input signal. You see the LEDs coming up. No clip. Now I got clipping, but look at the sine wave, it's not clipped. It's a very conservative clip indicator. Now it starts to clip, and now I have distortion and signs of clipping. Strong clipping here, both LEDs are lighting up. So, in my opinion, the clip indicator works well. And now I am performing the 1 kHz dynamic power test. That means I can check if the amplifier has some dynamic headroom. And the signal is a continuous sine wave and a burst of 20 cycles. That means 20 milliseconds, 1 kHz full power. And after the burst, the signal is reduced by 20 dB. So I'm trying to catch the burst, and I make sure that I have all cycles at the same voltage level. This is important because amplifiers can do 3 cycles of very high output power and then it goes dramatically down. And I'm testing 1 millisecond, 8 milliseconds, in this case now 20 milliseconds, and I want that all cycles are at the same voltage level. Here you see the burst. And it's not clipped. We have a higher output voltage. This is the last cycle. And if I catch like this, it says maximum voltage 100.8 volts. So I try to get to the last cycle. This is the last cycle. And I get 100.2. I want to be fair. I reduce a little more. I don't want to cheat higher values into the data sheet. And now I go to the first cycle. So I had 100.2 volts. Now I'm going to the first cycle. If it's higher. Yes, we also have 100.2 volts. That means we have all cycles at the same voltage level. Here you can see it. Burst, pause, burst. Every 480 milliseconds, the burst comes up, and this is a sine wave. This is what it looks like, and amplifier is not clipping. With 20 cycles, the amplifier delivers 643 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Let's switch to 8 milliseconds. Now I'm doing the same output power test, but this time I have 8 cycles of 1 kHz burst and then a pause of, I guess, 24 milliseconds. I observe the last cycle first. Now we go straight up to clipping. Oh, trig level is wrong. That's it, we see clipping here. I reduce a little bit. The negative waveform was starting to clip. Let's check this out. And we are at, it says maximum 105.6 volts. But I'm going to calculate with 102.6 volts. In this case, the amplifier delivers around 675 watts with an 8 millisecond burst into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Now I'm trying what I can squeeze out of the amplifier for just 1 millisecond with a 1 cycle burst of 1 kHz. And I try to catch it until it looks a little bit better like this. And it says 112.8 volts. I calculate with 111 volts. The amplifier delivers for just 1 millisecond an output power of 790 watts into an 8 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. You may ask why I'm doing a 1 millisecond test. The answer is easy. I saw a data sheet of a very expensive PA amplifier that was around 5,000 euros. And they did the test and put it in their datasheet. Now I'm doing the 50 Hertz burst test. That means 10 cycles of 50 Hertz. And I observe the last cycles. And you see we have clipped signal. I reduce my input signal until I have a clean voltage. And this looks okay. And we are at 94.8 volts. We have the same amount of output power like 50 Hertz continuous power, 576 watts. Now I'm doing the same test with just 5 cycles, that means 100 milliseconds, 50 Hertz. You see it, first cycle, second cycle, clean, and then boop, 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 clipping. The amplifier is going out of juice. That looks okay. So, but we still are at 94.8 volts. Yes, 94.8 volts. And this means we have the same output power like continuous power, 576 watts. With 50 Hertz, 5 cycles, and to an 8 ohm load, both channels driven. And now I have connected a 4 ohm load per channel continuous power test with 1 kHz. That's sturdy. I reduce, that looks okay. And I got a peak voltage of around, it says 79.2. I calculate with 79.2 volts. The amplifier delivers an output power of 804 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power, 50 Hertz. So I got a peak voltage of 76.8 volts. The amplifier delivers around 756 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power with a 50 Hertz input signal. Dynamic power test, 1 kHz, 20 cycles. I observe the last cycle. Try to get some more voltage. No chance clipping. That looks okay. I take the peak voltage. It says 87.6 volts. And yes, we are at 87.6 volts. The amplifier has a small amount of dynamic headroom. It delivers 984 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, 8 millisecond burst test with 1 kHz. And I observe also the last cycle. If the last cycle is starting to clip, I have to stop. Go with clips. Here we are. Some small amount of clipping is there. I take this one and it says 91.2 volts. I check the first cycles if we have some more voltage. It's also 91.2 volts. With 8 millisecond burst input signal, the amplifier delivers 1066 watts into a form load per channel, both channels driven. Now I test for maximum short term output power. All values are RMS values, by the way. And we have some higher voltage, 92.4 volts. Try to get more, but it starts to clip on the positive waveform. I reduce until it looks okay. Let's calculate with 92.4 volts. For just 1 millisecond, the amplifier delivers an output power of 1094 watts into a form load per channel, both channels driven into full power. As you know, usually would do a sound test of the amplifier like I do it on all the car audio amplifiers I tested before. But in this case, it makes no sense. The fans of the Pro Audio amplifier are way too loud to make a sound quality test. No sound test, I'm sorry. And here is the data sheet.
Enjoyed the video, and if you like it, why not leave a thumb? You can support my channel just by leaving a thumb, subscribe or comment. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.